हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स. इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी लर्न द प्रॉब्लम सेट नंबर 21 एंड दैट प्रॉब्लम सेट रिगार्डिंग एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइक फ्रैक्शंस. ओके, नाउ इन दिस प्रॉब्लम सेट नंबर 22 वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ फ्रैक्शंस बट द डिनोमिनेटर्स आर अनलाइक. Okay, so addition and subtraction of unlike fractions today we are going to learn. Okay, so first question is add. So the first fraction is 3 upon 8 plus 5 upon 4. If you see carefully students, here denominators 8 and 4. Okay, so now students, denominators are not same, means these are unlike fraction. Now listen carefully, when we are solving the examples of addition and subtraction of unlike fraction, that time first what we have to do, we have to make the denominator same. Okay, now how we have to make, look here, here students 8 and 4. So now you know the multiples nothing but the tables. Okay, so just I write the multiples of 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12. Okay, now if you see the multiples of 4 and 8. Okay, 4 and 8 are in the 4's table. Now multiples of, here I'll write multiples of 8. Now 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16. Now see here, 8 are common. Okay, so these are called multiples. Here the multiples of 4 and multiples of 8. Now what we have to do with these multiples? Okay, now look here, we have to make the denominator same, that's why we need the multiples. Okay, now next examples you will get better idea. Now here 8 and 4, if we had to make the denominator same, okay, so 8 if 4 twice means 2 times 4, that is 8. Okay, 4 twice 8. So here already 8 is there. If we multiply 4 by 2, then we will get the denominator same. Okay, now see when we will solve, then you will get the better idea. First, what we have to do, give equal to sign. First, 3 upon 8, this fraction as it is we have to write, plus 5 upon 4. Okay, now 4 twos are 8, 4 twice 8, so 4 twos are 8, so we will multiply 4 by 2. Okay, so this, when we multiply them, 4 twos are 8, we get the denominator 8. Here also denominator 8. Now the after solving this, denominator become same. Okay, so now here we multiply 2 to the denominator. Now the rule is, when you multiply any number to the denominator, you have to multiply by the same number to the numerator also. If you multiply numerator by a number, same number you have to multiply to denominator. Okay, so 2 multiply to denominator 4, so this 2 we have to multiply the numerator 5. Okay, 3 upon 8 as it is we have to write, plus 5 twos are 10, 4 twos are 8. Now see students, in this step we get the denominator same, 8. Now we can add simply. Okay, 3 plus 10, add only one time, because this 8 same, so only one time we have to take. So 3 plus 10, 13 upon 8. We got the answer 13 upon 8. Okay, now we'll see the, so but this is here only already 8 is there. Okay, so 8 is a multiple of 4, that's why we are doing this. But let's see in this example, if you see carefully the this example, this fraction 2 upon 3 plus 2 upon 4, numerator are same but denominators are different. Here denominator 3, a denominator 4, so we have to make the denominator same, then only we can add. Okay, now here if I write the multiples, and these multiple students, no need to write here. Okay, you can do roughly, no need to write directly, tables you have to make. Okay, so multiples of 3, 3 ones are 3. Okay, then I will write the multiples of 4. Now see, I write few multiples of 3 and 4. Why we are doing this multiples or finding the multiples? And here, see, 3 to the 6, 9. Here, if you see, 12 is a common multiple. Okay, 12 is the in 3's table also and 4's table also. So 12 is the multiple of 3 and 4. Okay, so this is a common multiple. Now we are going to convert this fraction into 12, or this fraction denominator into denominator 12. That's why I write this multiples. Okay, now this is very simple thing. Now first what we have to do, this example, first one is different, second one is different students. Okay, first write the first fraction, 2/3. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to take the second fraction's denominator and we have to multiply the first fraction denominator as well as numerator. Listen students, this is the simplest way to make the denominator same. Okay, what you have to do, if the denominator not same, then write the first fraction, multiply the first fraction by the second fraction's denominator. Okay, second fraction denominator. Now again write this, now second fraction we have to write 2/4, multiply. Now 2/4 is second fraction. Now I have to multiply this 2/4 numerator denominator by first fraction denominator. Okay, so first fraction denominator is 3. You are thinking, sir, why are you doing this? See the magic. Okay, 4 2's are 8, 3 4's are 12, plus 3 2's are 6, 4 3's are 12. See, 3 4 3 4, we got the denominator same. This is the magic. Okay, so we got the denominator same. Now we can add 8 plus 6 upon 12. 8 plus 6 14 upon 12. Okay, so we got the answer 14 upon 12. See, now in the first one already 8 is the multiple of 4, that's why we are not changing 8, only 4 which convert into 8. Okay, here 3 and 4 there is no multiples. Okay, so we write the multiple of 3 and 4, then we get the common multiple, that is 12. So we convert the denominator into 12 like this way. Now the next example, that is see, 5/7 plus 1/3. Now here 7 and 3. See students, when you are solving, always just think to the denominator. In the first one, 8 and 4, so 4 2's are 8, 4 twice 8, it is given. Here not given, you have to check the relation 3 and 7. 3 and 7, 3 2's are 6, so there is no relation here. Okay, so now we have to solve this example like this way. Okay, so first what we have to do, write the first fraction 5/7, multiply by second fraction's denominator, that is 3. 3 to the denominator, 3 to the numerator. Give the plus sign, don't forget to give the plus sign. Then write the second fraction, 1/3. Okay, now we have to multiply the second fraction by first fraction's denominator. So first fraction denominator is 7. So we have to multiply 7 to the numerator as well as denominator. Now 5 threes are 15, 7 threes are 21, plus 7 ones are 7, 3 sevens are 21. Okay, now here 15 plus 7 upon 21. Now 15 plus 7, that is 22 upon 21. Now we got the answer. Now these examples are not from the textbook. You got more examples. Previous problem said I choose one or two examples from the textbook, exactly same. But now for more practice, the examples are little bit same, but the numbers I change. Okay, student. So there are total 5 examples from problem set number 22 that you have to solve. Okay, addition. Now subtraction also 5 examples. Now same way to do here, only we have to do the subtraction. Okay, now see, 6 upon 15 minus 2 upon 15. I told first change, is there a relation between 5 and 15? 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15. So 5 thrice time, 5 thrice 15. Okay, means 5 multiplied by 3 we will get 15. So no need to convert this first fraction denominator, because only we have to change this, because 5 threes are 15. 3 times 5 is equal to 15. So as it is, this is first, like first example. So first fraction we have to write as it is, minus 2 upon 5. Okay, now only we have to convert this 5 into 15. So 5 threes are 15. Okay, and I told you, if you multiply denominator by a number, same number we have to multiply to numerator also. So here also multiply by 3. Now 6 upon 15 minus 3 twos are 6, 5 threes are 15. Now see, we got the denominator same. Okay, so now 6 minus 6 upon 15, 6 minus 6, 0, 0 upon 15. Okay, now this example, what I told you, the first step. Now see here, first change the relation 6 and 5. No, okay. So here we have to write the multiples of 6 and 5. Okay, but the simple thing, I don't, just this is for your information, you have to write the multiples. But simple thing, students, what I told, just write first fraction 5 upon 6. Okay, multiply by second fraction denominator to the numerator of the first fraction as well as denominator. Okay, then we are doing subtraction, so don't forget to give the minus sign, and then write the second fraction 4 upon 5. When we write the second fraction, then this second fraction's numerator and denominator we have to multiply by first fraction denominator. Here the first fraction denominator is 6. Okay, so we have to multiply by 6 to both numerator and denominator. Now 5 5s are 25, 6 5s are 30, minus 6 4 6 are 24, and 5 6 are 30. Now 25 minus 24, here denominator same, 30. So here 25 minus 24, 1 upon 30. Okay, like this way you have to solve. Now third example. Before solving, I told you, just check here in relation 10, 20. 10 twos are 20. 10 twice 20. 10 two times 20. So no need to convert this fraction. Only we will convert this fraction denominator, okay, into 20. Because 20 is a multiple of 10. 10 twos are 20. Okay. Like this, this one example, this example. This is also same example. 5 upon 10. Now multiply, we have to make the denominator 20. So 10 twos are, what the rules tells, when you multiply denominator by a number, same number we have to multiply numerator. So here we multiply by 2, numerator also we have to multiply by 2, minus 2 upon 20 is equal to 5 twos are 10, 10 twos are 20, minus 2 upon 20 is equal to 10 minus 2 upon 20. 10 minus 2, that is 8 upon 20. Okay, I hope you understood this, students. Only first, when you are adding and subtracting the unlike fraction, first check the denominator. If there is a relation means if the first or second fraction is multiple, okay, multiple of each other, then that you have to check. If not, then you have to write the first fraction multiply by second fraction denominator to both numerator and denominator of the first fraction, and second plus or minus sign you have to give according to the question. Then write the second fraction multiply by first fraction denominator to second fractions numerator as well as denominator. Okay, then you will get the both fraction denominator same. I hope you understood this. Now we'll move to the next practice set. Now students, we are going to solve problem set number 23. Okay, I think in last year you learned this. You have in your this kind of examples in your maths book. Okay, but students, what you have to do, I will give a simple trick to solve this. Whatever the explanation is there, the mention page on page number 30. So read that page number 30 2-3 times. Okay, now we'll directly solve the examples. Now see, these examples are different, questions are same, but examples are different from the problem set number 23. Okay, so each there are three questions, each having four examples that you have to solve. Now we'll move to the first one. What is 1 upon 3 or 1 third of each of the collection given below? Okay, 1 3 of 6 pencil. Now how you have to solve this? In the book, there are lots of steps are there. Okay, you can go through to that. Otherwise, look here. Simple thing, what you have to do, students, you have to divide this number, the whole number, by the denominator. Okay, here 6 divided to 3, 3 2s are 6. Okay, and what you have to do next step, this answer 2, you have to multiply the numerator 1, that is 2 ones are 2. Okay, now students, here we got the answer 2, so our answer is 2. Now we have to write here, therefore, what they ask, 1 third of 6 pencil. So 1 third of 6 pencil is 2. Okay, this way you have to solve, simple way. Now 1 third of 24 balloons. Okay, what I told you, you have to divide this whole number by the denominator, that is 3, then you will get 8. Okay, 3 8s are 24. Now what I told you, when you got this number, then you have to multiply this number to the numerator. 8, here numerator is 1, 8 1s are 8. Okay, if you see here, students, if 1 is numerator, then always you got the answer in the first step here also. But we are solving these examples again, there should be no confusion in your mind. That's why I gave the formula here. Same formula will be applied here. Okay, here you got the answer in the first step. Here also first step. No need to write this one. But for your information, I wrote this. Okay, so you have to write then again, 1 third of 24 balloons is 8. Okay, same way here, students, you have to solve. Now here the fraction is given, 1 upon 5 of each of the following. Okay, 1 upon 5 of 35 kilometers is equal to, first write the first, what do you have to do? Write 35, the number, whole number, divided by the denominator 5. Here 7 5s are 35. Okay, so again you have to multiply 7 to the numerator 1. 7 ones are So we got the answer. Therefore, you have to write 1 upon 5 of 35 is equal to 7 kilometer. Okay. Now this also 1 upon 5 of 40. First write this number 40 divided by the denominator 5. Okay. 5 8s are 40. Now again 8 multiply the numerator. Numerator is 1. 8 ones are 8. So you have to write therefore 1 upon 5 or 1 fifth of 40 rupees. This is the rupees symbol. Is 8. Okay. Now actually, as I told you before also, you got the answer in the first step. No need to write this one because already 8 ones are 8 here, 7 ones are 7 here, 2 ones are 2 here, 3, 8 ones are 8. But you have to write this. Why? Because here we are solving we are applying same formula here. Now in the third question, okay, here fraction is not given, the examples are given. Now see, find the part of each of the following numbers equal to the given fraction. Okay, now here 2 third of 27, 3 eighth of 40, 7 eleventh of 55, 5 thirteenth of 39. Okay, simple way, first write the number 27 divided by the denominator 3. Okay, now you have to divide 27 to 3. Here we get 9. Okay, now what we have to do? This 9 we have to multiply the numerator. Okay, so 9 multiplied to the numerator, that is 2. 9 2s are 18. So you have to write 2 upon 3 or 2 third of 27 is 18. Understood? That's why I write the formula here. Now 3 8th of 40. As I told you, first write the 40 divided by the 8. 8 5 is a 40. Now what we have to do? This 5 we have to multiply to the numerator, that is numerator is 3. So 5 multiply by 3. 5 3 is a 15. Then you have to write therefore 3 upon 8 of 40 is equal to 15. Okay. Now the next example, all you have to solve the same way, student. Again, write this number 55 divided by the numerator, that is 11. So 11 5 is a 55. Then this answer we have to multiply to the numerator. Okay. So 5 into 7, 35. Then you have to write the answer in full. Therefore 7 upon 11 of 55 is 35. Okay. Now here this also, students, this one more example. I not now explain. Same you have to solve. 13 multiply 39 divided by 13. So we get 3 here, and 3 multiply by 5, 15. Okay. So you have to solve this. So 5 upon 13th of 39 is that you have to solve. I hope you understood this, students. Now after this our chapter is over. Now we'll start new chapter, the next video, that is angles. Okay, so before start, if you know, you have lots of time now. So, read the 34, 35, page number 36, 37. Read the chapter, whatever the given notes. Okay, that is better for you. One more thing here, students. So one point left. Here the introduction of mixed fraction. Okay, mixed fraction. Now, what do you mean by mixed fraction? See, student, same example we will see. okay, you know the fraction. This is a chapati, three chapatis are there. This is one half and one half. Okay, if we add this, then see one half, that is one, and plus one upon half. So this one half is one and one half. So one is a whole number and a fraction. So if you see what is mean by mixed fraction or mixed number, so one whole number and one fraction is together called mixed fraction, okay, or mixed number also. Whole number, for example, now 5 3 upon 20, so this is also a mixed fraction. 206, 115, 3000, this is also a mixed number or fraction. This is whole number and this is fraction. This is whole number and this is fraction part. Okay, this is the only introduction. Now there is also definition is there, improper fraction. Fraction in which the numerator is greater than denominator. Okay, the numerator is greater than denominator are called improper fraction. So proper fraction means, see here, 25 upon 100, okay, numerator is smaller than denominator, this is proper fraction. Okay, and improper means 100 25, so numerator is greater than denominator, this is improper fraction. If numerator is greater than denominator, that is improper fraction. Okay, so this is only introduction, students. Now I hope you understood all this. Now students, one more thing I have to tell you. If when you are solving the examples, if you have any doubt, okay, you not understood, so try to solve that example, okay, at least 1 2 3 steps, and then you are not getting the answer, then what you have to do, take a photo and send me on my WhatsApp number. Okay, while sending, students, write your name, okay, your class and your division and whatever you have doubt, okay, then I will solve your queries. Send me on my WhatsApp with your name, class and division. What happened, many students are sending me the message of their doubts, but I didn't get the class and that. So better way, name, class and your doubt. Okay, I hope you understood this. So students, in the next video we'll start the angles. Along with that, I will give the notes of the angle also, but before that you have to complete up to problem set number 23. After this only you have to write the notes of the angles, and then we'll solve the first practice set of the angles. Okay, so though before next video you should be ready, means your notebook is up to date to problem set number 23. So complete up to 23, then write angles name in your notebook, then whatever notes I gave you, that you have to copy it, and then we are starting angles, whatever the problem set is there, that we will start. Okay, so complete your notebook, students, that is very important, up to problem set number 23. Okay, I hope you understood this. Till there, students, take care.